quote from Smith Wigglesworth. God never intended his people to be ordinary or commonplace. His intentions were that they should be on fire for him, conscious of his divine power, realizing the glory of the cross that foreshadows the crown. So why don't we lift our hands to heaven tonight? Father, we want you to consume us. We want to be consumed by you. However it works, whether we come to you or you come to us, whatever it takes, but we want to be completely consumed by you. So we pray for everyone in this room on our right and our left that Jesus, that you would mess them up for life. We didn't come just for a couple great days of encountering you, making new friends, and laughing our heads off. We came here as well so that we could be radically changed for the rest of our life. I pray for everyone in this room be marked for life. There's a marked change in their spirit. And we say, Holy Spirit, come, have your way in this room. Put your hand on your neighbor and repeat after me. Jesus, smash them. Mess them up really good. Now put your hand on your own heart. And Jesus, I want you to blast me. Everybody said, amen, amen. Let's worship. Let's go after it tonight.
Father, Son, and Thank you. There is We'll be right back. say something. I was in Vegas last night at a worship time, and there was a moment when I realized that you can't shut up a song that's been singing for ages. It sings through us. When we join our voices with heaven, with the open heaven that's with us, around us, in us, beyond us, above us, beneath us, everywhere. When we join with heaven, we tuck ourselves into the song of the ages, the song of hope, the song of offensive joy, right? The song of laughter that's medicine. It heals hearts and offends minds. Love does that. Love does that. It heals our hearts and it offends our minds in the process, and all we want is more of it. So I just feel this song of hope. I feel like we need to release this song of hope. We need to sing it out. We need to join with heaven tonight. We just need to let it out. We just need to let it out. Let it sing through us. Let it sing through us. Let it move through your voices. This song of hope can't be shut up or shut down. No.
Thank you. Thank you. Would you bring the lights up for me so I can see a little better? Great, thanks. I could hear you. Now I can see you. That's good. I could definitely hear you. Yes, I could. If you're able to stand, stand with us. We're going to take just a couple moments here just to wrap up this part of the evening and pray together. There's this interesting passage in Mark 7. Jesus is talking to a group of religious leaders, and he makes this statement. He says, you've rendered the word of God powerless by your traditions. Rendered the word of God powerless by your traditions. Just think about this for a moment. We just sang it a moment ago, that incredible song. He spoke and a billion galaxies appeared. The word is the most powerful thing in the universe, and yet the Lord has allowed us through our decisions for a season to have an impact on the measure, to influence the measure of impact of what God says in our lives. Are you thinking? To render powerless through traditions. Tradition could be anything other than what God is saying. Render powerless. It'd be like having the loudest guitar on the planet. It's a poor example, but you'll get the picture. Loudest guitar on the planet you can hear miles away, and somebody walks over to the wall and just unplugs it. Renders powerless. And the word of God has been released into our lives this week in such a profound way. Such a profound way. And I want to make sure that we're the ones that don't render the unlimited, powerful word of God and make it powerless. Do you get what I'm saying? I feel like God's deposited something in me this week. I've been provoked. I've been stirred. I've been ignited. I've been instructed. All this stuff's going on in my heart right now. And I feel like the Lord has brought us together for this moment of impartation. I think sometimes the greatest impartation is actually in the declared word. So here's what I want you to do. We're going to take just a couple moments for this. Put a hand on the shoulder of somebody next to you. Just get all kind of warm and fuzzy and lovey and all that stuff. How many of you understand that the Lord doesn't tell us to pray things he's not willing to answer? And when Paul models this prayer for wisdom and revelation, it's not a token prayer. It's because the Father is in anticipation of fulfilling that cry. I want you to pray for two things for the ones on your right and left. Don't you pray? Number one, increase the wisdom of revelation, number one. But number two, give them the grace to steward the word that's been given for this next season. I want you to pray that not one word would fail to accomplish all that God intended that was spoken in their lives this week. Lift your voices, pray for one another. Take just a moment for this. Increase the grace, God. Increase the grace to steward what you've said. Increase the grace to receive what you're saying. Increase our capacity for impartation in this room. Just being in the room, increase. Increase this, Lord. Increase this, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All right. You did good. Now put your hand on your own heart and pray for the person who really needs it. Let me just pray over you. Father, I do ask once again that you would release the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him, and that there would be such an unusual grace released, not only here in this room, but all those that are watching on TV. There'd be an unusual grace to carry out the very word you've spoken, not through striving, but through surrender. So we just say, be it unto me according to your word. Say that with me. Be it unto me according to your word. Say it again. Be it unto me according to your word. One more time. Be it unto me according to your word. Amen. 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 Yeah. Wonderful. Well, you know, we've had a couple days together. It's just been so fun.